This show is proudly brought to you by the Hashtag Me Network.
And now, Hashtag Radio NZ.
Welcome along to Hashtag Radio for your uncultured weekly roundup of everything web, tech, social media and gaming. I'm V8 Maddie.
I'm Chris McCawson.
And we've got no Fit McCawson.
No, I do believe he's getting his nails done at the moment. Priorities.
Oh, fingers or toes?
All.
Oh, he's gone for the full mani-pedi.
Yeah.
I'm not surprised. Disappointed, but not surprised.
Yeah, yeah.
Hopefully he comes out sparkling.
I do believe he's let the team down by not being here today.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, he has. It's a big show today, too.
We're
going to do our hashies.
Woohoo!
Which are the hashtag awards, where we decide the best and the worst of all the techie type things that have happened throughout the year.
It was quite hard this year. Doing the hashies?
It was. Nothing really sort of stood out and said, pick me.
Yeah. Is it becoming so normalised? Social and tech and...
I don't know.
It can't be that mundane. I found it quite mundane to come up with these.
Yeah.
Like I was scratching.
So was I. So you'll have to forgive us. If you don't agree with our list, then obviously share with us what you think should have won.
Mm.
There's probably a few things that we've forgotten.
Probably.
So they can't have been that great.
Yeah.
If we forgot about them.
Yeah. I can't even remember what was really? The beginning of the year. It was really hard. I had to go through all of our old stuff.
It's been like nearly a whole year since this year started.
Yeah. Yeah. And it's... what's today? Saturday, Christmas morning. No, Boxing Day.
Boxing Day?
Yeah.
What's today? What day is today? Oh, yeah, Boxing Day.
I had a lot to eat and drink yesterday.
Nice. What did Santa bring you?
Stuff.
Stuff
nice. I'm not allowed to talk about on radio.
Oh, personal stuff.
Santa's a very dirty boy.
Ever since he got that man bun.
Okay, so the hashies.
The hashies. What are we going to kick off with?
Should we start with Twitter?
Twitter. Our 2015 Twitter account of the year.
Yeah. So we've gone for the New Zealand
person
of the year.
So we've narrowed it down to a New Zealand person.
Yeah. You don't agree?
I do and I don't.
Yeah. So I put forward Lord at Lord.
Lord.
Yeah.
The young musician type chick that sings depressing stuff.
Yeah. My main reason for this was purely based on popularity. She's got 4.1 million followers. Her tweets end up in the news for some reason. So that's why I've gone for her. She's been, okay. Has been popular, therefore influential.
Her tweets end up in the news.
Yeah.
Can you recall an example? No, you can't.
No, I can't. Oh, yes, no.
Leading your news tonight, Lord tweeted about her jandals.
Wait, no, I can't remember anything.
No, okay.
No, so that's why I've gone for Lord.
4.1 million followers. Now, that is quite an achievement for a Kiwi.
Yeah. I guess.
Especially for a Kiwi musician.
Yeah. So makes her the most popular.
Based on that, we're giving Lord, at Lord, the 2015 hashy for the Twitter personality of the year.
Yay!
We should have organised some applause.
Yeah, we should have. I can do the applause. Yay! Okay. But I know she's going to gracefully accept this award and put it up with her other lots of awards that she's got.
That's right. We may even send a picture of a trophy to her.
A JPEG.
A JPEG.
Not a PNG. A JPEG.
Is that the best quality?
No.
Oh.
A PNG would be.
Oh, what's the difference?
JPEG gets there quicker.
Okay.
Mm.
I'm all about getting there quicker. Especially while Fid's not here, eh?
Next up. Best app. Who are your nominees?
The best app.
Yeah, because I've got a nominee as well.
Oh, what's yours? Forward.
I've gone with iHeart.
iHeart Radio.
Yes, the best app for 2015.
Now, mine was based purely on personal indulgence. So yeah. I was going with the Waze navigation app. Purely because they released the C-3PO voiceover.
Yes.
For free.
Yeah.
So you can have C-3PO from Star Wars giving you directions whilst you drive. And I think that is marvellous.
Yeah, I agree.
And that's all it took to sway me to get App of the Year.
Was C-3PO. Okay. Yeah, I will agree with that.
So we're going to go with that?
Yeah, we'll go with that.
Seeing as that Star Wars thing is kind of a buzz at the moment.
Mm-hmm. A kind of a buzz?
It is kind of a buzz.
It's got a little bit of traction.
It's so fantastic that I've almost been to see it at the movie theatre. I probably
can't believe
will.
You still haven't seen it, Matt. So I disappointed.
Know. I'm shocked. Oh, you're sitting next to my big Star Wars Stormtrooper poster, life-size poster of a Stormtrooper, and I still haven't been to the movie.
Shame on you.
Oh, dear. I've got R2-D2 sitting on my desk.
Yeah, do you know what I like about the whole C-3PO on Waze? Is it's not cheesy?
No, it's not. And you think it really could be with him.
Yeah.
It could be quite campy and cheesy. And
awful, but it's actually really pleasant.
Yeah. In 200 metres, turn left, Master.
Yeah.
I just like being called Master.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. I like it when it reaches a destination.
Mm-hmm.
And C-3PO gets all excited. That they're finally there.
It is good.
Yeah, I agree. Waze takes out best app of 2015.
Well done, Waze. And that's Waze if you're trying to find that app and install it.
Can you get it on Apple? I know you can get it on Android.
I'm not sure if it's on iOS.
Yeah.
That's a very, very valid point. Maybe we should go play a song.
Yes.
And we'll go and find out and we'll come back with whether or not that's available on iOS.
I am.
So,
What's the song?
Are we going Christmas tunes?
Are we?
Well, we'll start with one Christmas-ish song. This is one of the Killers. They do an annual Christmas song.
Do they?
This is their one from 2015. It's Dirt Sledding with the Killers. You're on Hashtag.
And we know it wasn't easy. You've been after me a long while, a pathological display. Now take a moment to imagine my dismay. When I heard you had a heart change, I was skeptical at first. Till you seen it for yourself, I guess you just expect the worst.
Said for being present, not just getting one. So pass the gravy and tap your toes. And don't mind old Jack Frost nipping at your nose.
Welcome back to Hashtag, and of course we are doing the Hashies.
Woo! 2015 Hashies are on.
So we've just given away the Twitter personality, New Zealand Twitter personality.
Yeah, New Zealand Twitter personality of 2015, at Lord.
And the best app of 2015?
The best app is Waze Navigation.
And that's purely because of C-3PO.
That's right. Star Wars Connection. If you can get something involving Star Wars for free, at the moment, you're doing incredibly well, so
yeah. They
deserve that win. And before the break, we were sussing out what platforms it's available on, and you've got the results?
Yes. So it is available, naturally, on Android, iOS, and, of course, the Windows phone.
Wow. There you go, Windows phone people. You don't have to use Google Maps.
Mm.
You can download Waze and be directed by C-3PO.
Yeah. Have you noticed that lately? Though, you know, once upon a time it used to be the two buttons, which would be you get it on Android, get it on Google Play, download it on Apple iOS.
Yep.
And now there's a third button I'm beginning to see, which is the download from the Windows Phone Store.
Nice. Welcome aboard, Windows.
Yeah. They must be pretty important if they get their own button.
That's right. Shall we go to the tech win?
Oh, okay.
As soon as we're talking about techie stuff.
Yes. What have you got?
My tech win nominee is Windows.
Oh, that was
Windows
mine.
For Windows 10.
I had that nominee too.
You had that as well.
Yes, great minds think alike. Why did you go for Windows 10?
I really like Windows 10. I had Windows 7 and Windows 8 on two machines.
Mm-hmm.
Both upgraded now to Windows 10 for free. And again, free stuff.
Yeah.
Free stuff is proving popular this year.
It is. I actually went for it because it was free as well.
Yeah. I just really enjoy Windows 10. I think it's a great mixture of Windows 7 and Windows 8. They've taken the best bits. They've added in heaps of great stuff, and it's just continually improving.
Yeah, Windows 10 actually made me jealous. So I'm a Mac.
You book. Are, true. Yeah,
yeah,
you're
I'm a MacBook Pro.
Apple ho.
Girl. I never used to be Apple ho. Screw you. Yeah, but I actually got really envious over the Windows 10.
Yeah.
And having to play with it.
And it's so much easier to spell.
Yes.
Than any Apple OS name.
I don't even know what mine. Oh, I think mine's Yosemite.
Yosemite. Yosemite.
Or is it Captain X? Captain.
El Capitan.
El Capitan. I don't know.
Yeah,
El
Capitan is the newest one. It's the mountain in Yosemite.
Oh, okay.
It's a mountain, yeah.
Is the next one going to be a river?
I don't know. They're kind of working their way up. Maybe the next one will be a cloud. Maybe it'll be Apple Nimbus.
Nimbus.
Apple Cumulus.
Yeah,
Who knows?
No, I agree. Windows 10, I found it really pretty, easy to maneuver. It had a start button.
Yay for start buttons. And the start button is the one that looks like the little Windows icon in the bottom left corner for those of you who haven't been enrolled in the course that I teach.
Mm. Plug.
Plug.
Okay, tech fail.
Tech fail. Now, there's always a lot of tech fails. We've got a few nominees for this one.
Mm-hmm.
What was your first port of call when you thought tech fail for 2015?
My first one was the GeForce GTX 970.
The NVIDIA GTX 970 graphics card.
Yes. Most unfortunate. Said it was 4 gig. It wasn't.
3.5 is pretty close.
3.5.
We rounded up.
500.
Normal rounding, if it's ends in a 5, you go up.
Is it?
Yep.
Is it actually? Oh.
Maybe not when it comes to the specs on a graphics card, though. But if it was any other number in any other situation, you could safely round that decimal to the nearest whole number and become 4.
Yeah.
From 3.5.
So there's quite a few people that have got the 970.
I've got one.
Yeah. And people had started noticing that it wasn't performing as well as it should as a 4 gig. And it was then later discovered that's because it's only 3.5.
Yeah.
And I found that to be one massive fail in tech. Either that or it's a packaging fail.
So, I'm not sure if it really is 3.5 or if it just really struggles with that last bit. Because the main complaints were that the card struggled with anything that required more than 3.5 of the 4 gig of VRAM.
Yeah.
Now, this is getting a bit nerdy.
Yeah.
But what it means is that when you were pushing it to the limits, it was hitting the limit well before it should have.
Yeah.
Turned out the problem was a genuine problem. And even some of the specifications given out to reviewers and stuff when the card was launched had incorrect information on.
Yeah.
It was described inaccurately and a lot of people were misled. So
yeah. I think that's a big one is when you start telling people wrong specs.
Yeah.
And then you get the product and it turns out to be wrong, you feel quite angry at being misled, and especially gamers who go through that gamers. Kind of issue.
Because they'll come at you.
They're not really known for being diplomatic.
No. Big voices from little heads.
Yeah.
But, yeah, so, I mean, that's a very valid nominee for a tech fail.
Yeah, who did you have?
I also had the Back to the Future hoverboards.
Ooh.
Now, they were meant to become real this year. There's been a couple of releases of hoverboards, but unless you've got a metal floor to fly around over, or you love the sound of weed eaters.
Are they weed that whackers, loud?
or a grass blower or whatever you want to call them.
Yeah.
They're just not hoverboards like what we wanted from Back to the Future. So that's a huge fail as far as I'm concerned. These other ones, the Segways without a handle, they're just you stand on it.
That's not a hoverboard.
That's bloody rolling on wheels.
Yeah. I agree. That's dumb.
I don't like that people are describing that as a hoverboard.
That's like getting those shoes with the wheels, the wheelies.
The Heelys.
Heelys.
Yep.
And saying that those are hover shoes.
Yes, it is. That's exactly right. Dirty lying swines.
Yeah, I felt tricked.
So, as far as tech fails go, I think hoverboards are right up there.
Yeah.
We had another nomination as well, and that was the Ashley Madison hack.
Yes.
Now, is that technically a tech fail?
Yes, because it's a breach, a data breach.
Privacy breach?
Cyber. They hacked
so
down
they
to
did
get it.
Fail. Their technology failed them.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then that was released to everybody, all the information. I found my own email address on there.
Yeah, but you put yours in as a tester, didn't you?
Yeah. Still, it was legit.
At least that's what you told Fit anyway.
I didn't show him any of the messages I got.
No.
Yeah.
But you've been very popular. You've got a lot of dates this year.
I've been going out a lot.
You have. For work.
Yeah, all those business trips,
yeah. It didn't really go anywhere.
Yeah, I've got another one to add.
Oh, another one. This is a busy category for tech fails.
It was Tidal.
Tidal?
Yes.
Yeah, what was that? Oh, it rings a bell?
That's the music streaming business.
Yeah.
That Beyonce, or Jay-Z.
Jay-Z set that Tidal one up to try and get more royalties for the artists.
Yeah.
How's that working out?
I don't think it's working out that well. Hence, fail.
Womp womp.
It could always improve, I guess. like next year with the hoverboard, they could actually make a hoverboard.
Maybe Jay-Z needs to get in touch with a real hoverboard creator and do tidal boards.
Yes.
That stream music while you hover. I'd buy that.
Yeah, I agree. That's pretty
cool. I'd even listen to Jay-Z if it meant I could hover. No, I wouldn't.
Okay, so which one are... Oh, no. So which one are we going to go for?
Oh, that's
tough. Quite a big...
It's a big category. Which way are you leaning?
I'm leaning towards Ashley Madison because it was such a big deal and it impacted on so many people.
Oh, that's valid. I really didn't want to go there with a dating website. how to cheat on your partner.
Yeah, I wouldn't really call it dating.
Well,
I don't think a lot of dating was happening on that site.
I think there were a lot of dates where things were happening.
This is true.
You know, Tuesday the 13th. I got it on with a dirty girl. The name Ashley Madison, I mean, that's the name of the person that created it, yeah? Or is that a made-up name?
I think it was a made-up name.
Why Ashley Madison? Did they do some market research into cheaters and they found that was the most popular cheater name?
I don't know. I remember when it launched too, Ashley Madison. And it being such a big drama.
Well, you were an early adopter of that type of website, I'm sure.
Yeah, it's part of the Ashley Madison Agency.
And what are
it
they?
It was originally founded in 2002 by Darren Morgan Stern.
Well, his name's not Ashley Madison, is it?
No. I don't think his wife was called Ashley
Were they
either.
Swingers at the beginning of that, were they?
I don't know. Not sure.
You still want to go with Ashley Madison?
Yeah, I still want to go with Ashley.
I'm finding it hard to justify Ashley, anything else based on purely on the numbers of people involved with that fail.
Yeah, so let's go with the dirty site. The dirty girl, Ashley.
Yeah.
Those dirty lips.
I hope we're talking about her smile. So well done, Ashley Madison. Tech fail 2015. You've won a hashy.
Applause all round. That's right, you sucked that bad this year. Oh, wrong choice of words.
Oh no, tech fail. That was huge.
Yeah.
And what worries me is that we had so many nominees for the tech fail.
And only one for tech win.
Only one for tech win. And that was Windows 10, which a lot of people are going to disagree with.
Yeah.
For the tech win of the year. But I think overall, as far as a free product goes, it doesn't get much better.
It was so widely adopted at first as well.
Mm.
Like, yes, there's going to be problems with it. It is free.
It is free. It is continually being updated and improved.
Yeah.
Just like any other operating system.
Yeah. Or any other Microsoft product.
Yeah. Or any other game.
Yeah.
You know? You buy a brand new game and then they're releasing patches and updates and stuff all the time. So I think it's just part of life these days.
Cool.
They can't get it right first time every time.
No. Okay, so tech fail, Ashley Madison, tech win, Windows 10. We should go to another song.
We should. It's great having no ads at the moment. We have to play more songs. Did you have anything in mind?
Do I? Yes.
You're going to surprise me, aren't you?
Yes.
I thought as much. We'll be right back after this wonderful song that Carice has picked for me. And you're listening to Hashtag.
Pop Danthology. I know that I failed you. I should have done you better.
Yes, I am bringing us back. Welcome back to Hashtag Radio with V8 Maddie and Carice McAwesome.
Yay. That was Popped Anthology 2015, part one.
And that's exactly why you didn't tell me what the song was before I got to play it.
Yeah.
Because I probably would have complained.
Yes, because it's a combination of all of 2015's top pop songs.
And I'm a grumpy old man. Some of those songs are okay. I have to give them credit there.
Yeah.
Anyway, that brings us to YouTube.
Yeah.
Now, we've got two categories for YouTube. We've got the best YouTube channel and the best YouTube video. Now, as you can imagine, there have probably been billions of hours of YouTube posted over the last 12 months.
Yes.
And it is really hard to pick something that everyone's going to agree with, so screw you guys. We're going with what we were amused by.
Yeah. This one was quite hard because nothing massively stood out. There's been so many videos.
Mm. And we're trying to avoid, you know, like, ice bucket challenges and all that sort of stuff.
Mm.
So any of those types of things we've kind of discounted.
Was there any of that this year? Because that was last year's,
yeah,
was ice bucket.
There was something this year, wasn't there?
I can't remember.
Oh, geez, I don't know. But we're not going to count any of that sort of stuff anyway.
No.
Because as far as I'm concerned, it's a virus.
You don't consider it viral, you actually consider it a virus.
That's correct. Some stuff is viral and other viral things are viruses that just need to be exterminated.
Yeah.
That's deep. A good spot for a Dalek to jump in and exterminate.
Oh no. So are we starting off with channel first or video?
Let's go channel first.
Okay.
Now, we've got a couple of suggestions that have been put forward as far as the YouTube channel. One of them being our very own Mitre 10.
Yes, Mitre 10 New Zealand. So I actually love this YouTube channel.
Because you're a girl.
Yeah, and it teaches me how to do stuff.
Because you're a girl.
Yeah, I get it that it's totally a marketing ploy to try and get you to buy stuff in order to make it. But it's all for the DIY.
Girls.
Yeah. And girls DIY? Yeah, we are. Totally.
Yep.
We do it ourselves. Power to the girls.
Do it yourself.
Yeah. So, the thing I liked about the Mitre 10 channel was all the videos made me believe I could actually do it, like build a retaining wall. They make it seem easy. It's not that easy. Just going to say that.
Retaining walls?
Yeah.
They are harder than it sounds. Eh? Yep. I mean, it's just a wall that retains, you know, a mountain. Can't be that difficult, surely.
Yeah.
But if the mountain was going to fall down, it would have done by now.
Yeah.
Do we really need a wall? Yeah, well, it'll look nice.
Yeah, it will look nice. But it goes into all the angles, wire things, chalk, dusty.
Stand by stuff. For technical jargon.
Yeah. And that's why I liked the whole Mitre 10. I liked the Mitre 10 New Zealand because it's all in our measurements and it's products I can buy here in New Zealand. The problem with other do-it-yourselfers is you can't find the products that they're talking about.
No, because they're telling you to get down to whatever store and it's an American store or something and we don't have it here and we're trying to think, what's the equivalent?
Yeah, what's the New Zealand name?
Yeah, and if I go in there asking for so many inches of this and how many feet of that, they're going to laugh at me.
Yeah, so Mitre 10 was one of the nominees.
So the Mitre 10 YouTube channel, get along, have a look at that, see what you think.
Yeah.
There's heaps of DIY videos for all sorts of things, not just retaining walls.
No, gardens.
Little things, big things. You name it, there's probably a video showing you how to do it.
Yeah.
Which is really cool. The next one, Tip Hero?
Yes. So you haven't seen Tip Hero before?
No, I haven't done Tip Hero.
Tip Hero,
the same sort of thing as Mitre 10, but with other things.
Yeah, Tip Hero is a cooking channel.
Oh, cooking. I like cooking.
And all their videos are under a minute 30.
That's pretty good.
Yeah.
I like doing things in less than a minute 30.
Yeah, it looks... I'll ask VH and Jen. The cool thing about the video is it shows you everything that you need, how to do everything.
Mm-hmm.
If you were to do it yourself, though, just saying,
it'll take longer than 90 seconds.
Yeah,
yeah,
it takes longer than that. But it makes everything look simple and easy.
And I'm all for simple and easy.
Yes.
that's how I choose my friends.
That's how I choose my husbands.
Well, he's my friend. I think we were talking about the same person. Anyway, sorry, Fid. We know that it's
so
hard.
Tip hero.
You just want to jump on the phone and tweet us and stuff, but you're getting your manicure done, so you'll just have to bite your tongue, buddy.
Yeah. And then we got another nominee, which was...
V-Source.
Yes, this is
which sounds like something disgusting. Something R-rated.
Oh.
V-Source? Is it anything to do with two girls in a cup?
No. this is quite nerdy.
Oh, I've crossed a line.
Yeah.
Okay.
So V-Source, this is your ultimate nerdy. This isn't geek. This is nerdy.
Okay. This is right and nerdy.
Yeah, this is a science orientated channel. It's quite cool. I really, really enjoy it. And I know...
Because you're such the nerd.
Yeah, Atford McAwesome actually really gets into it as well. Probably a little bit too much.
He's easily excited.
Yeah. And he kind of does need all the help he can get.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, to defend him a little bit, he does watch videos and things like that rather than doing those things himself, which is probably the best way.
Yeah.
Even with a Mitre 10 DIY video, I'd rather he just watched the video and felt that he could do it if he needed to.
Rather than...
But doesn't try.
Oh, poor fiddles.
Well, that's what happens when you miss out on the Boxing Day special.
Yeah, so the YouTube channel thing I found quite hard to try and find really good nominees. And so these three really spoke to me.
Yeah, I mean, there's some massive YouTube channels around.
But we've also got the inclusion of Facebook video now.
Ooh, Facebook video.
And so you're getting... see, Mighty Team New Zealand, Tip Hero, and V-Source both are on Facebook video as well.
Both all three of them?
Yeah, all three are also on Facebook video. So they've got their page, and they put all their videos on Facebook.
Yes.
But you're also starting to get pages that are purely Facebook only. And not YouTube.
Ah.
And then you're getting some that are just purely YouTube and then Facebook.
Ah.
So we might have to look at adding another category next year.
Or maybe just a generic video category.
Taking out the two platforms.
Ditch the format, or the platform rather, and just go with the format being a video.
Okay, so Maddie, I'm going to leave this up to you.
Oh, what?
For the YouTube channel, V-Source, Nerdy. Nerdy Science Channel.
What do they do, though?
They explain...
I can't decide a winner when I don't even know two of the categories. V-Source. Two of the nominees, rather.
So V-Source are the nerdy channel that discusses science and life. Then we've got Tip Hero, the cooking channel, and then Mitre 10, the DIY.
So do I want hammers and nails, food, or nerds?
Yeah. What floats your boat there?
Well, I'm a Kiwi male, so I'm going to go Mitre 10.
Mitre 10?
Anything that can teach someone else how to do something for me.
Oh, buddy.
That's good. That's good. And you thoroughly enjoy it yourself, right?
Yeah. That's probably the one channel I watch quite a bit. It's Mitre 10.
It's your go-to on a Friday night.
Yeah, I'm... realizing how sad my life is.
But at least on the weekend you get out there and then you actually build stuff.
Yeah.
You do make things. You do a lot of DIYing. And not just the girly arty stuff, but the practical things as well.
Yeah. So I build like barbecues and
stuff.
Good
on you. Hey, well done, Mitre 10. Best YouTube channel, 2015, Hashi Award winner.
Yeah.
Yay! Woo! Who would have thought? And we're not sponsored or endorsed or anything by Mitre 10, so there's...
No, but I'm thinking now we should be.
I'm thinking maybe they need to get you on to do some of their videos.
I can be there. How to make a fence.
Chick.
Yeah. Because that's all I can actually
You're going to appeal to a huge female demographic there, rather than... Or are you? Ooh. You're going to appeal more to the guys watching it.
Really?
Are the girls currently watching to see the guy do the building?
No, I don't. if they
he doesn't do it for you.
If they were spunky, they should put really hot, muscly men on those
Bring
videos.
That coxie.
I said hot, muscly.
Oh, the big dude, the Mitre 10 guy, Levi or whatever his name was.
No, too big.
Too big?
Yeah, he's too muscly.
Okay. Mm. It's quite a hard criteria to fit for you, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah. Have you met my husband? I have a niche.
You do have a niche.
Yeah.
For weird skinny dudes with nail polish.
Best YouTube video.
Now, you nominated the 6 foot man and the 6 foot water balloon, which is done by the Slow Mo guys.
Yes.
The Slow Mo guys, if you haven't checked them out on YouTube, it's all in the name, really. They film things in slow motion.
Yes.
And they do some cool stuff.
Yeah.
And this one was getting a 6 foot man into a water balloon.
A 6 foot water balloon.
It was tiny at the start, though. He only put his foot in it.
Yeah. And then he managed somehow.
And then he got his whole body inside it and filled it with water.
That's so insane and crazy.
And then when it popped, it was quite cool seeing it in slow motion.
Yeah, it's not exactly the most inspirational video.
No.
But I sat there and I watched the whole thing.
Yeah, you do, because you know it's going to pop.
Yeah.
And you're just waiting. When's it going to happen? When's it going to happen? What's our other one there? The people are amazing videos.
Yeah,
now, there's a whole lot of those around. We'll probably try and find our favourite one.
Yeah.
And pop a link up at some stage.
Yes. That was your one. And I'm kind of leaning more towards that. People are amazing. Because I sat there and watched a 15-minute one.
Yeah. These are the compilations of people doing extreme sports and things.
Yeah.
And it's not all extreme. Some of it's quite mundane stuff, but they're doing it awesomely.
Yeah.
And I think people need to be celebrated while we still have people to celebrate.
Yes, it's true. And very deep.
Yeah. Well, you watch the news and it's all bad people doing bad stuff.
Yeah.
You know? And you might get one short little bit about someone did something good. Oh, yeah, good on them. Let's go and look at some more doom and gloom.
Yeah.
So I think...
Do you think that's why those videos are so popular?
I think it is. I think people... you know, there's all the fail videos.
Yeah.
And they're good for a laugh, but when you want to be impressed and inspired, the people are amazing videos are the ones that you go to, aren't they?
Yeah. I think there's enough justification to confidently say that People Are Amazing is going to be taking out the best YouTube video.
I think so.
Yeah, I agree.
Well done.
Yay! We just got to find our most favourite one.
Yeah, we'll find a good one that isn't too long and is decent quality.
Yeah.
Because I'm a bit of a quality Nazi. And I don't like watching pixelated crappy videos. Thanks very much.
Yeah.
Not in this day and age. We've got good internets and good cameras. So many phones around that will record video in 4K. There's no excuses anymore, people.
Yeah. No reason for crappy video.
All right. And with that, I think it's time for yet another song.
Oh, I'll play part two.
Part two?
Of Pop Danthology. There's a part two.
Oh, my goodness. I'm so inspired.
Because there were so many amazing pop songs this year.
Okay,
then. We've still got to get through all the Justin Bieber ones.
Here's some more Pop Danthology. Thanks, Carice. You're listening to Hashtag.
Pop Danthology.
Yeah. Hashtag Radio NZ.
Welcome back to Hashtag Radio. We're doing the Hashies, and that was Popped Anthology Part 2.
I can't wait for Part 3.
I knew you'd love it.
Yeah, this is my I'm so happy phase.
And so now for the Hashies, we are doing social media fail and social media win.
Do we want to start with the fail or the win?
We'll start with the fail? Win. No, we'll do the win.
We'll do the win. Social media for the win.
Yeah.
And we're going to just go straight to the winner.
Yes.
Jimmy Jackson.
Yeah.
New By Zealand's far. Most popular Facebook guy who swears a lot, so don't let the children watch.
He's actually really popular with the children too.
Well, that's some bad parenting right there.
Yeah. So Jimmy Jackson's pretty much dominated New Zealand Facebook this year.
Mm-hmm.
With his little skits, his rants. He just really resonates with a whole bunch of New Zealanders.
He's doing well, just picking up on the Kiwi vibe.
Yeah.
We can all kind of relate to the stuff that he does. It's all stuff that we remember as children or currently, because he's a bit younger than me.
Yeah.
But, you know, it resonates.
Yeah. And so I think that's why we've taken him as the social media win 2015.
That's right.
Well done, Jimmy Jackson.
Go and check out Jimmy. Now, the spelling of the name, he's got like a personal one, which is J-I-M-M-Y, but his celebrity page, I guess you'd say, is J-I-M-I,
yeah.
Jimmy Jackson. Go and check him out. He's definitely worth a look.
Definitely. And now a social media fail.
Wah, wah. Social media fail.
Yes. So we've got two nominees for this, don't we?
We have, are we allowed to? Are we allowed to say this, given the platform that we're on?
Yep.
MediaWorks.
Scout. The Scout, the ultimate fail, business social media fail of the year.
Scout. Yep. So tell us about Scout, correct?
Okay, so Scout was, or is, it's still kind of going.
Oh.
It was a... supposed to be a social media news aggregator.
Okay.
And so it was supposed to take the news. I think this was the vision anyway.
The vision.
Was to take the news from people's social media accounts, aggregate it together, all this kind of stuff. They got a team in of all these young people. They brought over this woman from the New Zealand Herald, who looked after the gossip column.
I thought you were going to say from New York or something there, but no, from the New Zealand Herald.
Yeah, from the NZ Herald.
Yeah.
Brought her over to manage Scout. And within, I don't know, a day of it being launched.
A day.
Yeah, TV3's or MediaWorks' own journalists started mocking it.
Or harsh brew.
Yeah, because it ended up being a kind of stalkery celebrity news thing where they wanted pictures of people like, who's that guy that's on their channel? Or not even on their channel. He does the news, kind of.
Oh, that guy that does the news, kind of.
What?
Throw me a bone.
He's real loud. Short, opinionated, very right wing.
Paul Henry.
Yes.
I like him.
Was it Paul Henry? No, Mike Hosking.
Mike Hosking. Oh, yeah, he's the equivalent.
Yeah.
He's the pretty version of the Paul Henry.
Yeah. So someone.
I like both of those guys, though.
Yeah. So Mike.
Don't necessarily agree with everything they say and do, but I do like them. They're entertaining. They are opinionated, and I think it's hard to find people with opinions these days. Everyone's too cautious.
Really? You haven't been on Twitter for a while, I get it.
Oh, I've been cutting back on Twitter, to be fair.
Yeah, so Mike Hosking was vacuum cleaning his car, and that was the first news piece that Scout put up.
Woo! His Maserati.
Yeah.
Oh, I'd be vacuuming my Maserati too.
Oh my goodness, Mike Hosking is vacuum cleaning his own car. This is big news. Needless to say, TV3 journalists popped on to Twitter.
And took the piss out of their own
yes.
company's thing.
Yeah.
Okay.
And slowly from there, oh, not even slowly, it was quite quickly, very yeah. rapid.
Rapido, vamonos. Yeah.
It started going downhill and eventually everybody quit.
Oh.
Literally walked out. I don't even know if they've even got staff on or if it's still just that one chick.
So how did Scout work then?
From the Gossip Corner.
It was just, how did it become stalkery?
Well, that was the very first video that social aggregated news.
So that was done by a punter that was walking along and spotted Mike Hosking vacuuming his car and filmed him.
Well, that's the thing. I don't think it was even a punter. I think it was set up by the Scout.
Ah. Thing. But that's what it was meant to be?
Yeah, I think that was the vision originally.
Was to try and have somewhere that they could pull together all those random videos that people film because they were there at the time.
Yeah,
fail.
Yeah, and that was a massive, massive fail.
Did you say we had another contender for this?
Yes. So, the Christchurch couple. Caught rooting in the office window.
Rooting. Can we say rooting?
Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
That's good because I just said it like three times.
Yeah, they were having a shag in the office window across from a pub and got photographed.
And videoed.
Videoed, put on Facebook, YouTube, Instagram.
That poor lovely couple romancing each other in full sight of an entire restaurant full of people.
Only to discover that the man was married and the woman was engaged.
Two separate people, of course. Not to each other.
And I think the man's wife found out through Facebook.
I think so.
Yeah.
That is a bit of a social media fail when you are trying to be doing some sneaky at work lovemaking. And it's on the news.
It went so global.
It did.
And I couldn't... I know there's always circumstances and stuff, but when it comes to affairs, being caught out like that, that's pretty epic.
It's a pretty epic social media fail.
Yeah, it's karma at its best.
Yeah, I understand it didn't work out too well for either of those two people that were involved in that incident down in Christchurch.
And someone saying that she ended up leaving the country.
And being Christchurch, you just want to you want them to be playing a song or having something that says if the offices are rocking, don't come a knocking, which works so well with Christchurch with all the earthquakes and stuff.
Yeah. I don't know what staffs are about, like having an affair in the office that's across the road from a pub, or turning the light on when it's night time.
I know, because the glare on the inside of the window, obviously they couldn't see out.
Yeah.
And didn't realise that everyone outside could see perfectly clearly straight through that glass whilst they were doing things on a desk.
Yeah, I know I shouldn't laugh. You know, it's funny.
Shouldn't laugh, but it's funny.
Yeah.
I agree.
So what one are we going to go for? The massive MediaWorks fail of Scout? Or the Christchurch couple caught rude in the office window?
That's tough, isn't it?
Yeah, because you've got one that spent like millions of dollars for Scout, and the other one is just epic.
I think we'd have to go with MediaWorks.
Okay.
Because they actually intended to do social media.
Yeah.
Whereas the other guys just wound up on social media, failing. But it wasn't them that actually failed as such. You know what I mean?
Yeah, true.
So I think if we're looking at the category as a social media fail... Congratulations, MediaWorks and the Scout Project.
Oh, funny.
Yep. Epic. So that's our social media fail and our social media win.
Yeah.
We're getting down to the nitty-gritty now. We've got the last two categories?
Three
categories. So we've got our best mobile, talking cell phones.
Mm.
Best gadget.
Yep.
And the best game. Game of the year.
Shall we do mobile and gadget and then go to a song and talk about game?
Come back and do the game last?
Yeah.
We always do gaming last.
Yeah.
Okay, let's do that.
Okay. So best mobile. Who have you got?
Best mobile. I'm going with one that isn't even available in New Zealand.
Yeah.
Purely to draw some more attention to the fact that it's not available in New Zealand. The Sony Xperia Z5 Premium. Now, we can get the Z5.
But you can't get the Premium.
But not the Premium.
What's the difference between the Z5 and the Premium?
Premium.
Okay.
The Premium has a slightly larger screen. I think it goes from 5.2 on the Z5 to 5.5 or 5.7.
Mm-hmm.
It's also got 4K resolution screen.
Yeah.
Which is a pixels per inch, the pixel density of like 801, which is miles ahead of anything else. And a couple of other little things. So it's not a huge difference besides the screen. That's the main thing.
Yeah.
But we can't get them here. I'm gutted. I'd buy one. I'm still using my Sony Xperia Z2. I love about the Xperia phones. They have excellent battery life. They're waterproof.
Yeah. Not water resistant. Waterproof.
Waterproof. And they have high resolution audio. So for me, I use my phone a lot as a Walkman.
Yeah.
Listening to music with decent headphones and decent audio files. It's a mobile phone, so being waterproof is just a given. You can go out and do stuff. You don't have to stress about tucking it in your undies when it's raining to try and keep it dry. Not that everything in your undies is dry.
Ew.
It's summer, so it gets a bit sweaty. And a 4K screen. Who doesn't want a 4K screen? It's the first mobile phone to have a 4K screen. Bring it to New Zealand, Sony. Come on, Sony.
And this is true. I've nominated the Samsung 6 Edge. S6 Edge.
You can't even say it, so it shouldn't win.
It's the S6.
The Edge or the Edge Plus?
The range.
Just the range of the Edge phones.
Yeah, just the range. It's just a really pretty, good-looking, hardy phone. It works. It's reliable.
It's not waterproof, is it?
Oh.
Is it?
The Samsungs were one of the first to come out as being water resistant. I'm pretty sure you can go diving with it.
Yeah?
1.5. I have a look.
You Google that.
Yeah.
Google that. Good radio. Google.
Google. Show more.
So the Samsung S6, they the Edge phones, we did get one to play with early on, and it was a beautiful phone.
Yeah.
Credit where it's due. I'm not a big fan of the Samsung phones in general.
Oh, I love them, eh?
The Edge was really nice.
Yeah.
I have to give them that. The build quality was nice. It looked great. I think the Edge part of the screen is still a bit gimmicky as far as that goes. There was very little that it added as far as making the phone more useful than a different phone.
It's water resistant.
So it'll handle a splash or a shower.
Yeah, I think for water resistant, isn't it, that it has to be able to handle a meter? Or something?
I think so.
Yeah.
So the Sony you can drop into the toilet and leave it there and it'll be fine.
Yeah. Oh, you can do the same with
Which
Samsung.
Which probably would happen if you'd had it tucked in your undies.
Where it's wet and damp anyway, apparently.
Yeah. Speak for yourself. The Samsung S6 Edge.
Yeah, it's just a stylish phone that does exactly what you want it to do.
Okay. It's reliable. So how does that compare to having a 4K resolution screen?
It's got 4K.
Not the screen. The video will record in 4K.
Yeah.
But it doesn't actually have a 4K resolution screen.
Is the Sony the only one with it?
Yes.
Yeah, because it records in 4K.
Yeah, a lot of phones record in 4K now.
The display, I think, was Quad. Quad HD.
Well, that's technically 4K, is it not?
No, I don't think you can call it.
Quad HD, four times HD is 4K. That's what 4 comes from.
Well, it must be then.
Quad is 4. It can't be.
Yeah. Can't be. Otherwise, you'd call it 4K. Why would you call it quad?
Yeah.
Quad HD.
Confusing, aren't they? It's marketing spin. They're trying to make it sound more impressive than it is.
Yeah. Yeah.
But it's not true 4K screen like the
Sony. Yeah, because the camera is advertised as 4K, recording in 4K.
Yeah.
But the screen is advertised as quad. The specs that you get for it.
Yeah.
The screen's quad.
I don't know what they're talking about.
No, neither.
Which way are we going?
I'm sticking to my guns with Samsung.
You're going with the pretty phone?
Yeah. Good-looking, fancy.
Over the practical.
Over the phone that you can't actually get in New Zealand.
Oh, damn.
And that's the only reason why the Sony shouldn't get it, is because you can't get it in New Zealand.
Oh, I agree.
Otherwise, if it was in New Zealand, yeah, I'd give them.
I don't like Samsung, but I'm going to give them the win over the Sony because Woo-hoo! You can buy those phones here.
Yeah.
Well done, Sony. You've ruined it. Ruined it for everyone.
You lost.
You make the best mobile phones.
Samsung, well done. We took it out.
Yeah. What annoys me with Sony is that they need to sell phones.
Yeah.
To keep in the market. And if they're not even going to bring them here, how they expect to sell any?
They just want us to order it from overseas.
Bring us your flagship phone. Just send 1,000 over. I'm sure they'll sell.
Oh, no.
I can guarantee 2 sales. Guarantee. One for me, and I'll convince one other person.
Yeah, at least.
At least.
All right, best gadget.
Now, gadgets are a tough one to crack as well, because there's a lot of gadgets around.
Yeah.
It's been the year of wearables.
Yes.
So we've had to include the Fitbit.
Yep.
And the Huawei Watch.
Oh, yes.
Now, as far as other things go, we've got the Yoga Tab 3 Pro.
Oh.
That's the one with the projector on it?
Yeah.
I hope that's the right one, because yes, it's the one with the projector is the one I wanted to nominate, because I think that's it's more than a gimmick.
Yeah, it's actually useful.
Really practical and useful, especially for businessy type stuff.
Yeah.
When you want to do a quick PowerPoint or whatever,
you
can show everybody on the wall, just boom.
Yeah.
And you can lie in bed with it and watch stuff on the ceiling.
Yeah, which is actually how I use it.
Yeah, I bet.
Yeah, lie in bed, watch movies.
You wouldn't want to talk to your husband.
Nah,
put something on the... Play us a movie.
Yeah. Oh, that's quite hard.
Okay, pros and cons for the Fitbit.
Okay, it's... fitness watch. I don't know whether that's a pro or a con.
That's very true. It's very specific to its purpose.
Yeah.
I think based on its price for what it does, when you compare it to another smartwatch, if you're looking at buying a smartwatch for the fitness side of it, you're much better off going with a Fitbit.
Yeah, agree.
You're going to get all the stuff you want at a fraction of the price.
Yeah.
When it comes to an actual watch, though, the Huawei watch is fantastic.
It is so pretty.
It's round.
It looks like a watch.
It looks like a watch.
It looks legit like a watch. Yeah.
It's not one of those stupid
square
iPod
things.
Nanos with a strap on it.
Yeah, it doesn't look cheap. It doesn't look like a fitness thing either.
Yeah, and there's tons of variations on it too.
Yeah.
Colours and stuff. And strap options.
I like the fact too that I think it's the Huawei, is one of the few watches where you can just put on your own type of band.
Oh, yeah.
The straps.
I think there's a couple that do that. But not all of them do. Some of them are proprietary straps.
Yeah.
But, the Huawei watch is by far, if it was the award for the best smartwatch,
Huawei
would take it every time. But as far as a gadget goes, the Lenovo Yoga Tab 3 Pro is pretty cool.
Do you know what? I was talking about it with someone not so long ago, about one of the most simplest features on it is the stand.
Yep, you can stand it up.
Stand it up. And the amount of times where I've had it standing up so I can play music, or like a couple of days ago where I made pizza with the boys, so I needed the recipe. We just had it standing up.
Yep. I've done that myself with my iPad, but I had to get a stand to stand it up on, just for doing that sort of thing in the kitchen or whatever, with a recipe you want to look at.
Yeah. But the yoga tab comes with it. It's part of it.
Yeah. So it's that's
you can
good.
Have it hanging as well. It's got the
So what else does it do? Is it just a tablet? Or is it more PC?
Ooh.
Laptop-y?
I'd say it's more tablet. It's more tablet than PC.
Okay.
You can do PC stuff on it.
Mm-hmm.
But if you're trying to get the best kind of optimization out of your tablet, then go for it. Use it as a tablet, not as a PC.
Okay.
Yeah.
What's the winner? Best gadget. Hashi Award 2015.
Ooh, Fitbit, Huawei, or yoga? Should we go yoga?
I'm leaning towards the yoga.
Yeah. It's gadgety.
It's gadgety. It does more stuff than a Fitbit or a Huawei watch.
Oh, how interesting. Because last year for this category, I was totally against the wearables.
And this year we've got two wearables in the final.
Yeah, and this year
and
I'm like...
neither of them won.
But we might have to add another category.
We might have to get moving too, because we're running out of time real fast.
Okay, best game.
Best game of 2015. Now, there's quite a handful of possibilities here. You've got the Star Wars Battlefront, based purely on the Star Wars everything.
Yeah.
Fallout 4.
Yes.
Huge
yes.
game. Huge.
Fallout 4.
Have you finished the first level yet?
No, I'm still in Sanctuary.
Okay.
Fallout 4.
For me,
Forza.
The name V8 Maddie says it all. I'm going Forza Motorsport 6. Fantastic driving game. Really enhanced by having a proper wheel and pedals and stuff as well. I can't imagine a driving game without a steering wheel and pedals and stuff these days.
Star Wars, I reckon we should take out because it has no story. It's a cool game. It shouldn't really have a story because it's Star
Wars.
The
menu system on it is atrocious.
Oh, is it really?
Have you tried to join a party together and go in and do an online multiplayer game together? It's horrendous.
Oh, is it?
It's not intuitive at all. It's a terrible menu system.
Aww.
Shame on you, Battlefront.
Aww.
And considering the number of games out there that have those functions,
yeah,
for them to have balls that up, I think, is just a total amateur move.
I haven't had any trouble on the Star Wars game.
But you haven't played, like, tried to get in with a group of friends, have you?
No, no.
You try and do that. It's freaking nightmarish.
Yeah. Okay, so Star Wars out.
Star Wars out.
Okay, we got Fallout 4. I love Fallout 4. I can talk about Fallout 4 for ages.
What else was huge this year, though? There was more games
There's
than
heaps.
That.
Heaps.
Grand Theft Auto 5.
Yeah, Mortal
Third Com- year running.
Mortal Kombat X.
Mortal Kombat X, that was pretty epic.
That came out.
Street Fighter. That's not out though, is it?
Is it still not out? I think I've played it so often that I'm just assuming now that it's out.
I don't know, because there was all the failed beta and...
Oh, I was on that beta. How did it fail?
It didn't work. Remember they had to pull it and can it, and then about a month later they tried it again. And...
Oh, yeah. I got on both times. Oh, no, Fid didn't. Fid couldn't get on.
Yeah, Fid sucks.
Yeah, I could get on though.
Fitz going to bloody Las Vegas in a week's time.
Yes, yes.
Lucky bugger. That's right, we'll be here. You know, looking after his kids and stuff.
Yeah, you'll take care of us, Maddie. Fallout 4 or Forza?
I think we have to go Fallout 4.
Yeah, I agree.
Just on buzz alone.
Just the hype, and it was worth the hype.
So much anticipation for that game. All of the gaming events that we attended with all the pre-release hands-on, that game was never available.
Yeah.
Which I thought was a bit of a cheeky move.
But the hype, it was totally worth it. They didn't even have to give it out to reviewers.
That's right. They didn't give it out to reviewers. And no one got pre-release hands-on with it or anything, so no one could bag it before it was released, which I thought was quite refreshing, really.
Yeah, and I'd never played the Fallout, and now I'm addicted to it.
Yeah.
Addicted to the whole series.
Huge game.
Yeah.
Deserves the win. Congratulations, Fallout 4.
Woo!
Bethesda. You've done well there, my friends. And thank you for the t-shirt.
Yeah, that was a pretty that was a pretty intense hashies.
That was a pretty intense hashies, and we're out of time. I don't know what Fid's doing editing this show, but he's going to have a marathon.
Don't forget, you can, if you disagree or agree with
any
of
our hashies, your opinion. Don't hold back.
At hashtag me. Or hashtag Radio NZ, sorry.
At hashtag Radio NZ on Twitter. Check us out on Facebook, hashtag me.
Yeah.
And, of course, the website. We can download all of our other podcasts and stuff, hashtag me.co.nz.
And you can comment on the Instagram, hashtag me.co.nz.
See you.
Hashtag me.co.nz.